Christmas, everyone! You know, there is something in the world which is just as difficult to explain as an immaculate conception, and that is why certain things become popular. There's no rhyme or reason. There's no formula. You never know what's gonna take the world by storm. It's a complete crapshoot. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, biker mice from Mars, breadwinners, SpongeBob SquarePants, regular show. On paper, these ideas may sound like ridiculous brain droppings, but they all caught on and made buku bucks. But an even more inexplicable phenomena is the late bloomer, an idea which has been floating through the ether, available to everybody, but doesn't take on until much, much later. Take, for example, the band 311. You know them, right? All mixed up, don't know what to do, next day you turn around and find the person is you. Yeah, those guys. Well, they hit it big with their first single, Down, in the year 1997. The song was on the radio, it was a big-selling CD, the music video was played to death. The thing is, the CD had been out since 1995! If you don't believe me, they say it right in their song lyrics! In 1989, I was cocaine and Jimmy, but now it's 95 and I'm Trixie. Now I'm going for sale, the shit is on the shelf, it's 95, we go for the hive! Kinda weird, don't you think? You might even say it's like a Christmas miracle.
Well, the same miracle happened with an old Rankin-Bass Christmas special called A Year Without a Santa Claus. When I was a kid, there was an elite grouping of holiday specials which were required annual viewing. We had Rudolph, Frosty, Charlie Brown, Yogi Bear, Garfield, Sesame Street, The Muppets, and Twas the Night Before Christmas. The Grinch was up there for a while, but they took it away and put it on cable, the bastards. Then there were the Red-Headed Stepchild specials, the kind that were on Channel 9 Sunday afternoon after Christmas. The Little Drummer Boy. Nobody watched that boring shit. The Flintstones special with Teenage Pebbles and Bam Bam. I hate Teenage Pebbles and Bam Bam. And then I remember something about a baby New Year with big ears. Right in there was A Year Without a Santa Claus. I never watched it. I never cared what it was about. I lived a miserless young life.
And then I believe it started in the late 90s. I started hearing this song. That's right, the ever-popular Heat Miser, Snow Miser Duet.
A very old-fashioned, ragtime, but infectiously catchy little ditty. Suddenly, the misers were popping up all over the place, and everybody was talking about A Year Without a Santa Claus like it was some timeless classic. I was alive back then, and this was far from a classic. In fact, I watched it for the first time just a few days ago to prepare for this review. It was all right. It had that old Rankin-Bass charm. It moved a lot smoother than Rudolph, but was still stiff and jankety. Heat Miser and Snow Miser, surprisingly, were not the stars of the show. It was mostly a story about Mrs. Claus, two bungling elves, and a poor reindeer with two stinky, stanky socks on his head. I'll reserve judgment just in case I decide to review it sometime. I wonder how such an old-fashioned thing just all of a sudden became popular now.
Could it be the endorsement from Mr. Freeze?
Turn in my clutch!
Come on, sing! Louder, come on, sing, sing, sing! Come on!
He's Mr. Fox.
Yes, come on, louder!
He's Mr. Snow.
Now, here we are, 40 years later. We have the follow-up to A Year Without a Santa Claus, A Miser Brothers Christmas. It's a little scary to watch this. It could either take the miser's newfound popularity to new heights and introduce they to a new crop of young fans, or it could stomp any warm feelings you have about this property into the cold, cold earth. Whatever happens, this movie has one thing going for it right at the start. It has that song, that toe-tapping ditty, the Miser Brothers duet! Even if the rest of this movie sucks, we'll at least have that. So without further ado, let's start with the plot.
There is a hierarchy of beings who control the laws of nature, led by Mother Nature herself, to which the Heat and Snow Miser are charter members. The Heat Miser rules the balmy areas of the south, while the Snow Miser rules the chilly areas of the north. The two are in constant conflict, firing salvo after salvo on one another. Meanwhile, at the North Pole, Santa Claus has a new tricked-out hoopty, a post-modernized sleigh with all the accoutrements one could imagine. But the pompous, evil North Wind is jealous of Santa Claus's fame and he sabotages the sleigh, causing Santa to barrel right into Heat and Snow Miser's crossfire. The sleigh crashes, and Santa Claus is killed! Just kidding, he survives, but his back is completely thrown out. The North Wind blames the Misers for the incident, thinking this to turn his trailing winds of guilt cold and land he in Santa's driver's seat. But Mother Nature pulls a fast one, punishing the Misers by making they deliver the presents in Santa's stead, making the North Wind even more angry. Now, these two bickering brothers must put aside their differences and make that fateful ride, contending with the jealous North Wind all the while.
I am very conflicted about the way this special looks. I got this on a DVD, and let me tell you, if you told me that this was a Blu-ray, you'd have had me fooled.
It is so crisp and colorful that it pops off the screen. The backgrounds are real deep and vibrant, consisting of both real-made miniature landscapes and computer-animated backdrops. The two styles mesh beautifully and really capture that Christmas feel. The snowy landscapes especially feel very cold and vast. The animation is great. I do kind of miss the jittery movements of the original Rankin-Bass specials as they had their own charm, but this is good in its own way. I'm just happy that it's stop action. This would have been a way more miserable experience if this were computer animation. But at the same time, the new revamped look distances itself a little bit too far from its source material, and to me it oftentimes felt like I was watching one of those educational shows aimed at the younglings like Bob the Builder. A good holiday special should be accessible to all ages, and this one just has that 4 years and under look. If I didn't have to watch this for the show, this may have chased me away. There were times I actually questioned why the hell I was putting myself through this, as it was so juvenile and sugar-laced. But I kept telling myself, that duet, it's coming, business is about to pick up, I just have to be patient. The characters all look passable, I guess. That's as good a compliment I can give it. The redesign of Heat and Snow Miser is pretty cool, as they have large mouths and very expressive faces. They cutesied them up a little, though. I'm not too pleased with that. I preferred the juxtaposition of their original semi-scary appearances. Most of the other characters have those simple dot eyes and basic body types, almost resembling those peoples from Play School. Once again, this shouted Bob the Builder to me. Not a fan. But whatever, I'm not gonna try to slam the special too hard for that. This is obviously more aimed towards the youngsters, whether I like it or not. I hate what they did to Mother Nature. The character in the original looked like a real Yenta. I didn't necessarily love it or hate it, but at least it was a character. What did they do? What did they do? I feel like reaching out and slapping them on the wrist. They took away any personality this character had. I would take a Yenta over no character at all! Stupid ass shit! The look of the North Wind is a real mixed bag. I like the suit, I really dig the hair, and I love that little spiral-shaped cleft in his chin. But that head's gotta go. It looks like a giant kidney bean! It's big, it's clunky, and it doesn't animate well. And his mouth is way too small! When he's shouting or singing his windy little heart out, his mouth doesn't open wide enough, and I just don't believe the sounds coming from those lips! I mean, come on, it doesn't take a genius to see that this doesn't look natural! Let's talk a little bit about Santa Claus. He is once again voiced, if you can believe this, by Mickey Rooney, who has been voicing this character since 1970. Those of you who have been paying attention know that even back then, he wasn't exactly a spring chicken. Here, at his advanced age, you can hear just how much he's struggling with this. The way he weakly barfs out his lines. It's like he's having a boxing match with his old man jowls.
Weeks! It's Christmas! I'm Santa Claus! I have things to do! This is all ridiculous! I'm fine, I'm just... Ugh!
But, funny this, he was my favorite part of this whole special. For one, I love the idea that this special went out of its way to get Mickey Rooney for this part. It gives us old-school fans something to latch onto, a happy little bit of familiarity. And also, Rooney's befuddled, gravelly delivery is perfect for this character design. This version of Santa is kept very simple and cute, what with his innocent little dot eyes and squatty stature. The combo of the look and the voice makes this Santa one of the most impossibly charming Santas I've seen in recent memory. I commend them for this, though you gotta think this triumph to be purely accidental. Which brings me to the voice talents. These are some pretty hammy deliveries here, and it does grate on my nerves somewhat. Heat Miser and Snow Miser are supposed to be attention hogs. Hell, they even call Snow Miser a ham in the original special.
Here he comes now, the big ham.
But there's a whole lot more of them here, and they're turned up a few notches too many. They never, ever shut up. Plus, we have the North Wind on top of all of that, who delivers an equally obnoxious performance.
It's too much. Ba-da-ba-ba. Too much! Ba-da-ba-ba.
The voices of the Misers themselves, I gotta say they gave it a real good try. If you take the original special out of the picture, they're fine. The voices match the faces and body types pretty well. But comparing they to the originals, this Heat Miser's voice is a little too low, and Snow Miser's voice is a little too high. If only these two brothers would stop feuding and meet some kind of middle ground.
You know, I just found out at this moment something pretty awesome. The voice of Heat Miser, a fellow by the name of George S. Irving, is the same guy who did it back in 1970! How old must he be? Say what you want about the characterization, it's pretty cool they were able to get some of the original voices for this thing. I think for that they deserve a clap. One clap.
The other voices are bland at best, but there wasn't really a whole lot for they to work with. The voice of Mother Nature seemed especially bored to me.
I have something else in mind, as long as Mrs. Claus will agree. I had a feeling a little Christmas spirit is just what these two needed.
If you're not having fun, why should I have fun?
But don't lose hope, young viewers. That remake of the Miser Duet, it's on its way! It's gonna be great! I can taste it!
The plot is okay for what it is. Something to catch the attention of babies, maybe toddlers, but not any older than that. The main problem with this story is with its main characters. The Heat Miser and Snow Miser were never created to carry a story. In a year without a Santa Claus, they were an obstacle. They were the antagonists to our elven heroes. When the spotlight came for them, they commanded your attention, but that spotlight came and went sparingly. In that time, their charisma was infectious, their squabbling was humorous, and the way they gave in to Mother Nature like sad little kids, saying, "Yes, Mother dear," it was all endearing, because it was delivered in small doses. In this special, it's all we have. Constant G-rated bickering which gets annoying real fast. Their charisma dries up and they look more like buffoons with all the trouble they cause. And the way they kiss up to Mother Nature. "Yes, Mother dear. Yes, Mother dear." If I have to hear them say that one more time, I just wanted to reach into the TV set and slap around a bit and tell them, "Yo, stop being such pussies! You're two grown men! Start acting like it!" Man, I hated this! It worked on the original because it was just one bit at the end. The angry mother grabbing her two snivelly kids by the ears and dragging them out of the picture. In this, it's the whole movie. The whole thing. It takes both these characters' wit and charisma and flushes it down the toilet, turning them into two sissy mama's boys. You don't take side characters and give them their own movie. You just don't. Remember Cars 2? I used to love Mater. I actually cried when Lightning McQueen left without saying goodbye to him. I hate him now. I hate his fucking guts. All the love I once had for him is now gone because they took him and they crammed him into a shitty lead role in a shitty movie which played like a typical Larry the Cable Guy flick with a needlessly gigantic budget. Stop doing this. I implore you.
You know, I really hate to get into semantics about this romper room level production, but just because something is aimed at kids doesn't excuse it for being stupid. This whole plot makes no blankety blank sense.
As punishment for being such fuck-ups, Heat and Snow Miser are forced to do Santa's job on Christmas night. Why would you do that? They're fuck-ups! That's like getting rid of a hangnail by throwing a lit M80 on it! There. Your hangnail's gone. It's gone. The hangnail's gone. Your hangnail's gone. This is the stupidest solution to a problem I've ever heard. Let's teach these two naturally opposing forces to coexist by making them do this very, very, very important job together. Shouldn't they start out a little slower? Maybe they could build a toy together? No? Is that too logical? Does Mother Nature not give a shit about the kids? What a bitch! And for that matter, why is Santa Claus always so quick to cancel Christmas? He never even tries! When even the slightest hurdle is put in his path, his first instinct is always, oh, Christmas is canceled. In Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, it was a snowstorm. It's the freaking North Pole. When isn't there a snowstorm? In this special, Santa throws out his back. Ooh, tough break, you old geezer. What a mystical figure that Santa Claus, huh? But the worst excuse by far is from a year without a Santa Claus. Christmas is once again canceled, and why?
I don't feel like it this year. I'm tired.
You work one fuck day a year! Tired. Fuck you, Santa. You know who I always felt bad for? The elves. What happens to all those toys they spent the whole year building when Christmas is canceled? Do they just push them into the Arctic Ocean? Can't you just picture the elves with little tears in their eyes? And for that matter, Jesus! What gives Santa Claus the authority to cancel someone's birthday? Isn't Jesus gonna be a little bit pissed off? Can you not have Christmas without presents? It makes no sense.
But believe it or not, with all the reindeer poop this special has been cramming into my eye sockets, it is nothing compared to the gallons of liquid diarrhea it funnels into my ears! The music in this special, holy, holy hallelujah.
I can tell you what the melody is supposed to be. You listen to the MIDI soundtrack playing behind these songs and it hits the correct notes. They're not catchy in the slightest bit, but at least they kinda qualify as songs. But the singing. The singing is... what's the proper word?
There really is no other. Brothers should be friends.
Awful?
Let's huddle tight for Christmas night is ever drawing near.
Putrid?
It's Christmas time, a jolly time. It's sleigh and snow and holly time.
Odious. There it is. Odious. That's the word. While other specials would clean things up in the recording studio, you can tell no such thing was done here. They had to have sang these songs karaoke style, all in one go.
When I was alive and young, I was in school chorus, so I know the way these things work. I couldn't sing worth a damn. In fact, none of the kids sans maybe one or two could actually sing. But since there were like 60 of us, we drowned out each other's weaknesses. In this special, the choruses must consist of three people at most, none of whom are great singers. And even worse, they try to harmonize!
It is a recipe for disaster. Listen to this.
It's Christmas time, a jolly time, a sleigh and snow and holly time.
To eat a holiday fruitcake would be a more pleasurable experience. And my God! What a letdown the North Wind song was. The villain's song is often the most fun ditty of the picture, but here it is so flat and off-key you just want it to end as soon as it began!
They won't miss Santa! There won't be a Santa! It's over!
No, it's not.
It's over.
No, it's not. It's over. No, it's not, because my ears are still hearing it!
No, Santa, just me!
But there is one song they cannot possibly screw up! The very reason I, as well as anybody, would tune into this festive holiday tripe! The thing I have been harping on again and again! The now iconic Heat Miser Snow Miser duet! It's coming up next! It's coming up next! I can feel it! Hear it coming! It's coming! The redemption of the Miser Brothers comes now!
I'm Mr. White Christmas, I'm Mr. Snow. I'm Mr. Icicle, I'm Mr. Ten Below. Friends call me Snow Miser, whatever I touch turns to snow in my clutch. I'm too much. I'm Mr. Green Christmas. I'm Mr. Sun.
He's Mr. White Christmas. He's Mr. Snow. He's Mr. Icicle. He's Mr. Ten Below.
I never wanna know a day that's over 40 degrees. I'd rather have a 30, 20, 10, 5 than let them freeze!
He's Mr. Green Christmas. He's Mr. Sun.
Shut up!
He's Mr. Heat Blister.
Shut up!
He's Mr. 101.
They call me Heat Miser.
When does it
Whatever
end?
I touch starts to melt in my clutch.
He's too much.
I never wanna know a day that's under 60 degrees. I'd rather have it 80, 90, 100 degrees.
Too much.
Mercifully, it's over!
He's Mr. White Christmas, he's Mr. Snow.
Again?
He's Mr. Icicle, he's Mr. Ten Below. Friends call him Snow Miser. Whatever he'll touch turns to snow in his clutch. He's too much. He's Mr. Green Christmas. He's Mr. Sun. Love ya! He's Mr. Heat Blister. He's Mr. 101. They call him Heat Miser. Whatever he'll talk.
Oh, my ever-loving lord, what did we do to deserve this? Not since George Jetson wrapped with a robot have I so wanted to hide my head within my own skin. It literally sent uncomfortable twinges up and down my spine. That is not an exaggeration. It really happened. I mean, even notwithstanding the music, look at it. Where's the fun? Isn't it weird just how there is so much more animation in this special, yet the characters seem to do so much less? Look at the original! They were tap dancing, they had the hat and cane, they were doing little pirouettes! In this, it's like they're both frozen in their tracks with their gigantic heads taking up 98% of the screen! And I hate the reprise where one is singing about the other. Why don't you just give each other BJs while you're at it? Where's the Snow Miser's little... Why isn't he doing that? It's his trademark! Was that it? Weak sauce! Man, Dick Sean, that's the original voice of Snow Miser, is spinning in his grave! And why is this song 48 minutes long? Why?
One star! That's the easiest reading I've ever given out!
Aside from Mickey Rooney's exhausted portrayal of Santa Claus and a crisp artistic flair, there is no reason, I tell you, no reason to ever watch this. It doesn't even feel like a Christmas movie. It feels more like a lame attempt to take an old property and capitalize off its resurgence in popularity. I wonder why. I felt like everything in this movie annoyed me, but most notably, the music. Every attempt was a misfire, so terrible they even somehow messed up the one song we already know to be good. If you have a musical with shitty music, it mars even the best production. So what happens to a lackluster special that happens to have shitty music? It makes it lower than low. I'm sure over the years, more and more people will discover the Miser Brothers. And my biggest fear is that people will flock to this special because their names are right smack dab in the title. I pray to the North Star that people will find these two characters in a year without a Santa Claus and bypass this puddle of hangover puke. I'm not saying it was the greatest special. Hell, there was a reason why it wasn't required holiday viewing way back when. But it was tolerable, the Miser Brothers were used sparingly, it had great music, and it felt Christmassy. Four things I cannot say about this. Up on the housetop, click, click, click. I hope the heat and snow miser fall off the housetop, and the click, click, click is the sound of they breaking their spines! Bah, humbug!
Damn it! Damn it! I really needed this to be good. I need to get into some kind of holiday spirit, because here in Limbo, the days, they just kind of bleed together. I don't even know anymore when one day begins and another one ends. What's Christmas to me? I have no one to share it with. Just my dogs and well, that guy, but he's more of an idea than a friend. Nah, Christmas is just another day wallowing away in this box. It's like I'm a gift that's stuck behind the tree that no one sees and never gets opened. Hark, what is that I hear? A knock? No, that's not possible. I'm floating in the middle of nowhere, literal nowhere. How could I possibly have a visitor?
Merry Christmas, Djclyve!
Who are you?
I am Ushkermouse. You probably don't remember me because I was your chum in your former life.
How are you here right now?
Hello, Santa's messenger? I can do lots of cool stuff you don't know about. Here, I have a gift for you!
What is it?
It's the first review of your second season, and I think you'll like it!
Oh, no, you didn't! No, you didn't!
Do I know you or do I know you?
Lost your mouse! What a pal!
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. May your heart be light.
In a year our troubles will be out of sight. From now on...
No, stop! Don't do the James Taylor version, for crying out loud! You're depressed enough! You're gonna want to slit your wrists!
Sorry.
Have yourself a merry little Christmas.
Your heart be light.
From now on, our troubles will be out of sight.
A merry